jacks and ain't seen my missus.
Been on my jacks
and I ain't seen my ain't the way the saying goes, that you're in bad company when you're alone. Well, I'ma pull up every memory on my English rose. While the sky turns close to further, I'll get lost in your nine letters.
Your nine letters.
There's no need to be cryptic, addicted to missing a point, cause I know that I'm better.
I'm better.
When you're there beside me,
side me, side me, side me, side.
Passenger and sightseeing,
sightseeing, sightseeing, sightseeing, side.
Dust from the dashboard. Pink sky, wildlife, fiasco. But
it's been a piece.
I just wanna hold your hand.
It's been a
minute, wishing I could understand.
It's been a piece.
I just wanna hold your hand.
It's been a
minute, wishing I could understand. How you do it like that?
When was the last time?
Did we build it up?
When was the last
that I gave up?
When was the last
didn't
time?
I didn't chase the clock.
When was the last
that I felt a lot.
When was the last
made that free on the truck.
When was the last
time that I held your hand?
It's been a minute.
I just wanna hold your hand.
It's been a
minute. Wishing I could understand.
It's been a piece.
I just wanna hold your hand.
It's been a
minute. Wishing I could understand.
So we've got League Leaders going into today's video. That is the second to last game, I'm pretty sure, of the league. And we've got 21st in today's video, Norwich and Watford. I'm passing to Scotland, a small one, to Australia. April, October to the 14th of October. Let's check. The last time Luongo was out on international duty, we had to replace him in our team. So 8th to 14th. Yes, he'll be back for the Coventry game. Thank God. He's out from there to there. Which is good news, because last time Luongo was out on international duty, we had to play Dele Bashiru. Colin Grant is playing for Huddersfield, he is no longer there. He's at West Brom now.
This is the kind of occasion we all relish as football fans. Non-stop hype all week long. And now for the action. Hello everyone and welcome. What we can't complain about today is the weather. Absolutely perfect playing conditions. I'm Derek Ray here on the commentary box, and I'm joined for commentary by Lee Dixon. And what we have for you is live action from the Championship. It's Sheffield Wednesday, and they take on Huddersfield Town.
Well, thank you, Derek. Glorious atmosphere here. Really looking forward to it. The fans are too. The players look like they're up for it. This could be end-to-end. We could get goals today, Derek.
Josh, a good start to the video. Nope.
Juninho Bakuna.
Okay, I'll take that. Pippa.
Into the advanced position. Richard.
In the line.
It looks promising. Dangerous ball.
Powell's there.
And not an attempt he'll be terribly proud of.
Just to watch the Huddersfield Town man head over. Well, wide. Photograph of goal kick.
Well, we can now go to Alan McInally for news of a goal elsewhere.
There it is now. Patson chases onto it. Watford winning again. We take the lead this time over Wickham. And we take the lead over Huddersfield. And it is a good goal straight away from Massimo Luongo in the 10th minute.
Well, in this replay, you're going to see a 2v1 against the keeper. How does that happen? He'll be asking his defence why he's left exposed. Nothing he can do. 1-0 then.
Really showing off his wide range of passing skills. Toffolo.
Grant. We need
to take
an eye on this game. And Bannon can head it away. No, he can't. No.
Really good high press.
Scottish midfielder.
This attack looks highly promising.
I did that advance over by Palmer. Can't get fully cleared. Huddersfield Town volleys it towards goal. And volleys it towards goal again by Colin Grant, but offside. Got to test this free kick then. Can we get a second, and that's an advantage for us.
Advantage in operation.
And that advantage ball's didn't gone. Take long because they're now going through with Colin Grant. Volley's 1-1.
Can you believe what we've just seen? I think we're going to be viewing that goal.
Oh my god. Ayofa is down injured. Not something we would want this game. In fact, let's keep him on. Yeah, I'll keep him on for now, won't it? Because it's only a classic, so he can easily get back.
Well, take a look at this again. No finer sight than watching a player catch a volley so sweetly. Look where it ends up. It's a beautiful goal.
Well, the earlier goal cancelled out. What a miss.
No, he can't.
And let's join Alan McInally because I believe there's been a goal in the Middlesbrough match. Alan,
it's a goal for Middlesbrough.
23 minutes played. 1-0.
2-1
up here. Alan McInally.
Colin Grant. And good defending, but apparently it hit the hand of Tom Lees. And it is a penalty to Huddersfield. Penalty on the field. If it loads, it always does for penalties, don't know why. Let me just see, did it hit his arm? No. But Colin Grant had the chance to put Huddersfield 2-1 up. Grant, and he does, comfortably, good down to the right, bottom right. Huddersfield from 1-0 down in the 10th minute. They now lead within 7 minutes, 20th and 27th. Now we have work on our hands to try and stay into the top 6.
It's been scored by Sammy Amiobi. A triple well worth watching on the highlights before we dig.
There is now Winder. He is onside. He just can't get it though.
Well, they've lost possession of the ball.
We should surely score past Ben Hamer because he is shit. One of the shittest keepers in the championship, in my opinion.
It's with Juninho Bakuna. Now, counter-attacking possibilities here.
There is now a payback by Ayofa, but he wins the ball. There is now. Can Windass get it? Yes, he does. Windass plays it back
can
up.
There
is now
here.
Patson through to Reach. Reach now over the top. And that is
and
the equaliser.
Well, now that could
Colin
be a
Patson.
Huge turning point of this game. They carry the momentum.
Well, as we see, it's a great cross, but what a finish. So hard to wait and be patient when the ball's dropping. He does everything right and finishes it off. A brilliant goal.
So Kyle Patterson's on 9 goals. This kaleidoscope of shifting emotions. One more goal over this game, putting on double digits. Double figures.
Caro, 18.
Pichard. Can we get a third goal before half time?
It is to be a throw-in.
And a filling game.
The high press was very much on.
If I believe Izzy Brown is not at me because he is out injured for a thing.
Massimo Luongo. With a good reading in the game to win possession back. Richard. And we will have a couple of additional minutes at the end here. Not to be advised giving the ball away there.
Yes, it was.
Can they forge ahead?
And Colin Grant.
And you've got to say
a goal, an extra goal, 3-2 up.
Well, here's the replay, and the keeper knows that near post should be his, but he left a gap and he got punished.
Slightly different vantage point in terms of the goal that was scored.
So, not well-deserved goals from Huddersfield, but hey-ho, we've just got to come out second half. But Reach was on the counter-attack just for half-time as well. Could have gotten in on goal, but yeah. Robbie Woodrow to Coventry. No, he's not played as of yet, which is saving them embarrassment.
As anticipated, plenty of talking points so far. And now the second half is underway.
Another equaliser, so it went from us winning to them scoring an equaliser, then going ahead to us scoring an equaliser, then ahead now again. But Eric Patterson, and he couldn't quite squeeze that through.
A slight delay as the ref clears the defenders.
That's a good ball.
And he slipped and he screwed the ball wide. Didn't even make the goalkeeper make a save. 48 minutes played. It remains 0-0.
Alan McAdary
with his finger on the pulse. Adam Reach.
And here is Massimo Luongo. He scored one this game already. He scored a second. No, he doesn't.
He just couldn't make it happen.
No, he doesn't. This is still 3-2 Huddersfield. Not well deserved lead from a rival, but
Kongolo.
It's what it is.
And it's with Schindler. I think most fans would be pretty happy with this man's display so far.
Wow, it's simply the difference between these two sides. All the eyes will be on him for the second half. Can he get the hat trick?
Good shot.
Good defending,
but penalty again. A penalty again.
Fuck off. The referee might well have been tempted to book him.
Good defending, but penalty. Penalty again to Colin Grant to try and get a hat trick. Colin Grant does get a hat trick, and it's 4-2. Not a well-deserved two penalties that should not have been penalties. Two easy penalties that should not have been penalties. Huddersfield does not deserve this lead that they have got. But what it is, and then I can't get past the fucking sixth defence, man.
It's a goal for Bournemouth. 61 minutes played. 1-0.
Thanks, Azabo, for the update, Alan.
Huddersfield's got 5 up. No, they don't.
Taking care of business defensively here. This might be the perfect counter-attack
Callum
opportunity.
Patterson now plays it down, and here is Kadeem Harris to try and get it back to 4-3. Try and get back to a goal for the teams, and yes, he goes. Kadeem Harris, 4-3.
Cut into their advantage. Still plenty of life in this match.
Yes, would have been 3-3 if the referee
well,
did that
again.
Penalty.
It's
that
all about
not
the pace
there.
In transition.
Would have been
it was so quick to get out of the back.
Both
but then there's still plenty to do from here. Under all
penalty.
Sorts of pressure from the defender. He just about keeps him at bay
what?
And finishes
it
with a block. Great goal.
And was back on the car.
Well, about this.
That pass for the wrong goal was not a good pass. Can
shielding the ball superbly.
Now. Without referee giving away any more penalties.
Can they get in behind them? Richard.
They're defending, but Matt Pellett gives it away. He's offside, surely, and he is offside.
Offside. Well, close one.
Referees actually gave something away for a change this game. Doesn't take it. Please give it away. I offer.
Barry Bannon.
Plays it through. One now, lad. Make it through. Here it is now. Josh Winder. It's wide of the post. It's wide. And I think there's going to be a few changes going to this game now. Rose on for Patterson. Windass off for Elias Kachunga. So green. Being a more attacking player, it works for us.
So making the substitution now.
Kind of go into our favour with Rose.
And news coming through of a goal on the Middlesbrough game. Alan McAnally can tell us more.
It's a second goal for Brentford. 76 minutes.
2-2. Thanks very much as always, Alan.
I've enjoyed him with Brentford's goal.
Rose Brentford gets
it
on the flank.
It lead it to a goal.
And he's in.
No, they don't. And that time, the referees actually not gave a penalty for the
defending.
And that is
well,
the right. 10 minutes ago.
Exactly
one got
I'm
off
not
for
sure
Alex
what
Hunt.
He did there, and he caught it on the top of his head. But whatever
one
he did,
thing
it's a poor
back
attempt.
To roof for him, but that was the
please.
First thing that came up. But.
Well, this is the home of live football and
here
more
is,
live
man.
Action from the Championship coming your way
Jordan
on EATV. It's Sheffield Wednesday up against Coventry City.
Yeah, really looking forward
Kadeem
to it. Always a
all
great
over
atmosphere
there.
In that stadium. It should be a really entertaining match.
We're losing this game.
5 minutes remaining.
Not
and one thing is certain, no one is leaving because it's still close.
Game. But here it is, Carlin Grant. Plays it down.
Benza.
And Benza. Good defending. By Matt Pellett to cover it.
And
he gives it away. He gives it away.
Dangerous.
Matt Pellett
just
gives
cleared
it
away in
but
the nick of time.
He's run back. Bannon now plays to Kadeem Harris. He ain't catching up Kadeem Harris. He is not catching Kadeem Harris up. Kadeem Harris plays it in. And it's wide open up by Jordan Rhodes in 90th minute. 90th minute, Jordan Rhodes putting it wide.
Well,
not be doing with that, going wide. We need this ball. We will lose this game. And we have lost it. Not
the
deserved loss.
It goes into the history books as a home
sake,
defeat.
Man.
Lee, your thoughts?
Two penalties that should not have been a fucking penalty. This ref is a joke. Go down to 7th now. Great. Ref Robs doesn't even get knocked out of top 6. Surely Coventry now should be 3 points back. Then we've got six Birmingham. Will Birmingham be six going into our game? We beat them yesterday in real life. Can we beat them now, today, after this game? So we've got 18th first. So we've only got three wins. Norwich have got to have won now. They've got to have won and they did win. They beat Stoke City. They've climbed up the table slower, but we've got them as well. We have got them. So we are currently sat eighth in the league table. After Middlesbrough have played 13 now. A win for us will take us back, could take us back into the top six. Hopefully it will. We have got Coventry, then Birmingham, then Watford, then I think it's a cup, and then Norwich. Let me just go to team management a minute. Think of Coventry game. Yeah, is Brown's out injured? Think of the Coventry game. I shall bring on Van Aken for Tom Lee. One goal for Del Bashiru. And then Adam Reed can go on the bench. And Windass can go in camp. So we're making three changes. We're making a midfield change, we're making an attack change, and a defender change. But keeper can stay. I'm not going to risk swapping keepers around. Is losing and I have to take Dawson Wildsmith off of Dawson. I'll play Wildsmith in the cup game now.
This is the kind of occasion we all relish as football fans. Non-stop hype all week long, and now for the action. Hello everyone and welcome. What we can't complain about today is the weather. Absolutely perfect playing conditions. My name is Derek Ray. With me in the commentary box is Arsenal legend Lee Dixon. And we're on the cusp of bringing you live action from one of the most exciting leagues in Europe, the Championship. It's Sheffield Wednesday and they take on Coventry City.
Yeah, great to be here. How lucky are we, Derek? We get paid for this. Astonishing, really. Looking forward to a fabulous game. I'm sure the fans are too. Should be great.
Callum Patterson.
Can these three changes to the side of this game?
Well, for Sheffield Wednesday, well, it's all about an improvement. I say that because they lost in the last game against Huddersfield Town. How do you think this is going to go, Lee?
Well, scoring three goals, you expect to win the game, but they lost 4-3. They've been working hard on the training ground this week. I predict a win today.
Can we get the first goal of the game over B?
And use of a goal on the Luton Town match. Alan McInerney can tell us more.
Yes, it's a goal for the home team. 9 minutes
Luton
played.
Are 1-0. Thank you, Alan McInerney. Good news for us because we go above Brentford as it stands with a draw.
Well, the table looks like this, and however way you slice it, for Norwich City, below expectations up to this point.
Well, the start of the season, most pundits, commentators, myself included, thought they'd be competing for the title. Still a way to go, but they're pretty off the pace, they really are. They need to recover, and recover quickly. Form's gone out the window, confidence shot to pieces.
Can they forge ahead?
There's it through now. On Harris.
Looks promising this.
Kadeem Harris now. Harris.
They could nudge in front.
Patterson, another defensive.
Good
shot.
Defending to prevent the chance.
Two good
timing promising, but they got nothing out of it.
By
the fans can sense they have the momentum
and
here, creating plenty of chances.
Nil,
can they make it count?
Not with this contact, please.
A move of promise on the flank.
It will cross it in. It will head it. And it will go wide.
I'm not sure what he did there when he caught it on the top of his head, but whatever he did, it was a poor attempt.
That is a good pass. Windass plays it through and can Bannon lead to us having a go. Can a captain lead? No, he can't.
Couldn't hang on to the ball.
So our captain can't lead to a goal. Patson can't. Harris can't. Who will be able to?
And across the touchline, so a throw in here. Hearing there's been a goal in the Luton game. Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Brentford. 28 minutes played.
Back
1-1.
To
regular updates from Alan McAnally along the way.
Back to Windass.
Moving
back
the ball
to
forward
Patterson.
With purpose.
And again to Windass. Plays it through it to Bannon. And that is one. And that is a well worked goal.
The pressure finally telling. And they get their due reward.
Well, here's the replay. And that passing and movement is pure quality. And he chooses to use power in the finish. Not much chance for the keeper when he's hit that hard.
The opening goal of the game then. Giles
now, can he get towards
Liam Kelly? And in one of the other games, the referee I'm hearing has pointed to the spot. More details from Alan.
It's a penalty for Brentford. He's put the ball down on the spot.
Brentford have a penalty now.
Little step, fooled the goalie. Good strike. 34 minutes played. 2-1.
Thanks to Alan for the update, Alan. Then Rama on the scoring, but not there in real life now.
Disappointingly, he got completely underneath that.
Here's a coaching tip. Long range shot, lean back, equals over the bar.
I almost listen to you coaching tips, Lee.
Patterson is in on goal, and this could possibly be two.
Can he finish?
It is two. Patterson.
They're looking really relaxed and confident, and not giving the opposition much of a look in.
And that is his 10th. Goal of the season.
Well, here it is, a strike as Brennan puts that simple finish, but it's the positioning that gets him the goal.
It's going their way, 2-0. Matt Godden.
The visitors' possession stats are brilliant, but after that it's been disappointing. I'd like to see them use those wide areas around the defence, get around them as opposed to trying to go through the middle.
But will
and the electronic board showing one additional minute.
Bannon. Give it away. Give it away, and that is half time. And I think I'll just skip it to result. And it is finished as a 2-0 win. 31st minute goal from Bannon, 40th minute goal from Patson. Gives is enough to give us 3 points. And what a game that is from Luton and Brentford, 3-2 to Brentford. Hopefully we have got back into the top 6, and we have indeed. Middlesbrough has played a game, so every team has got a game in hand on Middlesbrough. And possibly... And they have also got a game in hand on... No one, just Middlesbrough. Oh, and Luton. Getting on the Middlesbrough and Luton. So both Midlands teams, Forest and Derby, are both 3rd and 4th. 36 now. We could go up to 3rd again with a win. This time I'll use this quick sim, not quick sim, I use a sim feature. We've got Scott Hogan on. This is exactly at the ground like it was at yesterday. But not the exact same lineup. Thank you.
and they kick off here.
So the Benin say, I've got Jonathan Lekko, I'm guessing, yes he has. Lucas Rukovic, Pedersen, Sanchez as well.
Adam Reach. Possession changes hands, the interception there. Real danger. Options in the middle. A meaty but fair challenge, and it will be a throw-in. An attack full of promise. The keeper was never likely to be in trouble then.
Is that going out, or is Windass going to keep that in? He's not going to keep that in. Yeah, he's not keeping that in.
There's a goal kick here. Hogan. Well, that's one for them to pursue. Well,
chance for Birmingham to defending. Good defending by Matt Penny there to get it out of harm's way.
Adam Reach.
Luongo, Patterson, play it down to Harris, can't find Harris.
And they'll get ready for the throw-in.
Birmingham now pushes forward.
Mikel San Jose, and now with Šunjić. A fine use of the ball. Defensive efficiency personified.
We get on the counter now to lead to a goal.
Barry Bannon. Massimo Luongo. And that puts them in position.
Bannon's Windass, but Windass is offside.
Patterson, Liam Palmer.
When I play through to Windass, I will jump in for this counter attack. Is he going to keep that in again? I don't think he is. He is. He kept that in, but it was out. Oh, I was ready for our throw-in. I'll take this throw-in.
Has gone over the touchline for what will be a throw-in.
From Windass to Liam Palmer. Back to Windass, who is onside there. And Patterson's head are just right of the post.
Great chance with that header, but he sent it wide of the post.
Well, it's quite easy to head that one over the bar. This time he just gets his angles wrong, just past the post.
Not a great
Windass
pass.
Tried to play through that gap to Patterson.
Crowley, dangerous looking through ball.
And he is offside.
A badly timed run, just a fraction offside. Liam Palmer. Well, sitting deep like this might be a dangerous game. Still passing it around with authority. Šunjić. Hogan. Oh, great vision. Cross towards that far post.
Half time, we'll have that. Half time. 0-0.
Underway then in the second half. And the two teams matching each other just about stride for stride. Harris. A really committed challenge, and it's gone out for a throw-in. Adam Reach. Harris. Less than convincing defending. And Nottingham just a bit too high in the end. Chance to play it in. Firing it towards goal. And he's kept it out, fully stretched, somehow reaching it. Dangerous looking attack.
Campane. Has Penny got anyone with him? He's going to have to play it back.
Life is never dull in the Championship. Live action coming up for you on EA TV. It's Birmingham City taking on Blackburn Rovers.
Yeah, the fix is coming
can
thick
we
and fast.
Get this
should be a good game,
I that.
Hopefully,
that
that's not the commentator's
fix,
curse.
But obviously, not. Got a good challenge. Plays it through now. Can it be?
Pass.
That's one. That is one. We are 1-0 up now, thanks to Adam Reach. A well-deserved goal by looking at the stats. Four shots to two. Two chances to one. 62% possession, 38. But it looks a bit, we did deserve that lead as well.
Final 20 minutes here.
Jumping in, we did get the lead.
Team. Nice ball to switch the point of attack. Mikel San Jose. They look as though they want to make this move count. Bella are still searching for the equaliser, but not passing it anxiously. The keeper making sure that there were no scraps to feed on for the attackers. And a throw-in forthcoming. Šunjić. Here they come, still pressing for an equaliser. Leading to the centre.
Sufficient guile on the toxic front, you've got to say. Fans are now jumping for the final counter-attack that could lead to 2-0. Will Harris get it? Yes,
this
he does.
Promising.
Kadeem Harris plays it back. Plays it through to Windass. Well, it was offside anyways. And that shot was, don't know where that shot was going
he
to.
He had such a pity for them. Chance was on.
So we've got, it's 90 minutes.
1 minute remaining. And he read it superbly.
And Patterson
showing excellent
now.
Vision.
Patterson with 20 seconds to go. Cat attack is on. Callum Patterson. Patterson. And that will be full time then.
He had to react and did.
Yes, it is. Full time 1-0. Winning goal by Adam Reid. Djukovic here on the 80th minute for Hogan. I thought it was a run on Djukovic when they were struggling before 80th minute. But Norwich has won again. That's two wins on the roll for Norwich, but it's all against Wickham, like. But they was doing so good. But we are back up to third in the table versus the league leaders now. I'm hoping league leaders got Watford, Derby, and I'm guessing they have. Because I'm still third. Derby lost their game. No, they drew to Rotherham. Derby drew to Millwall, so good news for us, we are third. We are 7 points behind the second position now, Bournemouth. We can't afford to lose this game against Watford. Watford Cup final game against Norwich for today's video. Can't afford to lose to Watford. Who have they got on their team? So it's top versus third. They've got a pretty strong team out with Saar and Deeney as the two strikers. I'll change to that for this game. 4-5-1 attack. If that does not work by half time, I'll change it back to 4-3-3 attack.
And so the match is underway.
On the bench, who have we got on the bench? Lamora.
On and on he goes.
No.
Will Hughes.
James Garner.
Saar in possession. Tom Cleverley. Hughes. Deeney. Really vital interception here. Callum Patterson. Patterson. Not showing good vision. Just knocking it around, looking to carve out a chance. And he's clear his lines. That's how to rob them of possession. Will Hughes. Saar in possession.
Oh, that lads.
Christian Cabasele.
Don't let them go 1-0 up. If Will Hughes. It's going to be a goal this game. Capu. Come to us.
They really look after the ball when they have it.
I offer.
That's a foul. And it will be a potentially
it's Mary
Saar
will take it.
Well,
they
was close to free kicking
number 90 to kick
just
two.
Didn't quite get enough dip on it, did he?
And almost
the going
ball,
in,
but I thought it was going
well.
In. And Windass will chase that ball,
ball
now. He is onside.
An attack full of problem. He's in behind.
Windass to play it in. Harris to shoot.
To get
Bannon
the
to get it. To cross it in. Patterson to head it. And I thought that hit a Watford arm.
in danger. Etienne Capoue. And Hughes has it. Deeney.
I did think that hit a Watford arm.
And Deeney on the ball.
And thought we were going to get a penalty there. But
and Hughes has it.
Obviously not.
Chance to cross.
Chance to cross it in and just pass it in.
Oh, he's really up on the
and save by Dawson.
Not out of the woods yet. Danger averted for now. Tom Cleverley. Christian Cabasele. Etienne Capoue.
No, not bad against Capoue. The league leaders with the mid formation. Apart from possession wise.
And across the byline, a goal kick as a result.
Banning out to Matt Penny over Callum to Patterson to Kareem Harrison.
Let's get him
to
the ball edge now. Of the opposing attack.
Deeney will play it through.
Capoue.
Can it's nearly a star. Deeney 1-0. As we would have expected. 1-0 Watford. Last to the arm.
Plenty to consider based on what we've seen so far.
And get a goal.
As the second half begins.
A 1-1 draw, I'll be happy with it. Due to
Bournemouth. News coming through from one of the other matches. It's a penalty award, Alan McAdally.
I'll be more than happy with it. But I think we might have to change it back.
Wayne Rooney.
To 4-3.
He's putting the ball down on the spot. Here he comes. Opportunity.
And that's 2-0. That is 2-0 now. 50th minute. And I will need to change it back to our original formation. Luongo off. Kachunga going that centre mid spot, even though they're right mid.
Oh, that's two.
And got by
Cordina. They simply can't stop him. No wonder he's celebrating.
Well, we've got a better angle of it here. He was aiming to pretty high.
To the league leaders.
No chance
can't afford to lose this game, but
it's going their way.
They're the league leaders for a reason. They're not going to make it easy for us. No team's going to make it easy for us. Even if you smash him, they're still not going to try and make it easy.
A goal has been scored in the Bournemouth match. Alan McAdally.
It's a second
but
goal.
It's an advantage, and Deeney will get to the ball if it's really trying by Iorfa.
That is how to apply the pressure.
Patterson will get fouled, and it's a
free kick awarded by the referee.
Iorfa with the yard card now.
And they're making a change. Rather than stop play immediately, the referee waited and now decides on a yellow card.
Try to play through, but couldn't play through. We need this. We need a goal back. We need a goal back. Can we get this goal
really
back?
Starting to dictate the tempo of this game now.
It is
over
the top to Messina. Messina now looking for a chance to go three up, and he does. He takes it. And we will lose this game, meaning I'll jump to result. Finish 3-0. So, smashing defeat against Watford. Not what we would have wanted. I'll quicksim Sunderland. I played my first team against Sunderland, I'll quicksim it. Then we've got Norwich. And it finishes 2-1 with Windath and Rose on the pitch. We will agree to put them 1-0 up. So we are through to the next round of the Carabao Cup. We're fifth now. We can still go second after Norwich win. Well, after not game. So, Norwich is our final game on Halloween. This will be on 31st of October.
And the contest begins. And across the touchline, so...
Have I kept that same formation?
Throw.
Yes, it's back to 4-3-4.
In here. Harris.
Harris looking for the proper penalty. Penalty, well, right, it. To Patterson, but doesn't. And Harris to get the ball. Can he keep it in? I don't think he will. Yes, he does. Patterson, Harris looks for his cross. That is our throw in. I'll take this throw in. And then I'll get back out of it.
It's a perfect challenge. Well, it was a foul, but good use of advantage by the referee.
I get out of it now. So, Reitz is getting that yellow card.
Early challenge of an illegal nature, and the referee can't ignore it.
We've got the bench, Timo Pukki. No, they haven't got Timo Pukki on the bench.
Tom Tribur. McLean.
That is an advantage for that.
Wendia. Oh, nice ball.
Selling.
Kenny McLean now. And he read it well. Emiliano Buendia. Gibson now. And there to intervene. And the ball lost here. Dowell. And the emphasis is on creativity. Offside by a fraction. McLean. McLean. Tom Tribur, and using his strength to shield the ball. Every pass hitting its target. Space and time for the cross. He's in behind. Was an important piece of defending. Quintilla. McLean. Looking for that final pass. Looking for the goal that would put them ahead. It's got to be.
One a lot.
And it's in.
Struggling Norwich, quick lead over us.
The opening goal of the game then. Options in the middle. Well, that is a defender's job to come to the rescue. A good looking move. Oh, that's a fine pass. An attack full of promise and a significant block following that cross.
I can't wonder Norwich.
The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Hugo. Quintilla. Tom Tribur. And news of a goal in the Luton Town match. Alan McInerney can tell us more.
It's a goal for the home team. 52 minutes played. 1-0.
Alan McInerney keeping us right up to date. Emiliano Buendia. What a shocking pass, really. Well, this really ought to be a championship game to savour. It's live on EA TV. It's Sheffield Wednesday facing Cardiff City.
Well, that
should be a really interesting matchup atmosphere. I'm sure we're going to get an absolute belter, Derek.
Just so we don't, hopefully don't go off on a...
30 minutes left for play in this match.
Don't mind going off on the draw, but I would more prefer to go off on a win. But the win is not going to happen, especially if they score that. It could still happen, but I don't think it will happen.
Wanted to keep it, but couldn't.
So here it is now. Now it's a Brendio will cross it in. And
therefore
will say, down that path. But
and
the
play stops, they will make the change now.
Plateca off the top of Cantwell, crosses it in by Brendio, headed by Cantwell is now on it. And that is a corner kick again. Patterson off, Rose on.
Join Alan McInerney now because there's a winner goal in the Bournemouth game. Alan,
can reach that
goal
for
Bournemouth. 67
minutes,
2-1.
Thanks as goal for the update. Rose, who's just come on,
well,
gives away a free kick.
And it sets up a free kick in a dangerous
off
position.
Kachunga. There's a free kick in a dangerous position. Rose, no booking for him. And it was Rook Buendia to take it, and it hits the wall, straight corner against the wall, Todd Kick.
Let's see if this will help them add to the lead.
Buendia takes it, Todd Kick. Todd count, well, can we get this equalised in goal, or will Norwich double the lead?
Can't miss,
Dawson,
still alive.
After several chances to clear it, we do clear it, but it's back, and a penalty to Norwich. Tom Lees is penalised that time.
Well, a judgment call for the referee. Many an official would have cautioned him.
Ah. Tom Lees will come to that. Here is McLean. And saved by Dawson. It is saved by Dawson. And Dawson leaves it for some reason. Dawson leaves it. And that's 2-0. Why the fuck did Dawson leave it? Why the fuck did Dawson leave it? What the fuck is happening here, man?
Goal
after that, I think Dawson's getting dropped from Wildsman. That having said, he's coming out just to fucking leave it. The absolute prick. He's an absolute fucking prick, man.
This looks promising.
Come on, Windass. Get this goal back. Come on, Windass.
Just couldn't get it
through. Oh, Rose, so man. Why the fuck was you stopping at first, man? For fuck's sake. On Wednesday, going out on a defeat.
The visitors have totally controlled possession,
but Dawson just makes over and
relaxes the team. If you've got the ball, Dawson, you enjoy the ball, and they're turning it into goals as well.
Waiting for Dawson, we could have actually drew this game, but it's a second league defeat in a row. We will come out of the playoff now after this game. And I'm not blaming anyone but Dawson.
He's in behind.
And 3-0 and game over. Dawson is shit. I will drop him for next game now. Dawson is getting dropped. Wildsmith will come in for Cardiff. We are staying in the top six. We stayed in the top six then. We have got lucky and let off there.